إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذني الله وإياكم منها أيها المسلمون أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فإن الوصايا ليس هناك وصية أعظم من الوصية بتقوى الله عز وجل بل إنها كانت وصية الأولين والآخرين قال تعالى ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله خل الذنوب صغيرها وكبيرها ذاك التقى واصنع كماش على الشوكة يحذر ما يرى لا تحقرن صغيرة إن الجبال من الحصى يا من بدنياه اشتغل وغره طول الأمل وقد مضى في غفلة حتى دنا منه الأجل الموت يأتي بغتة والقبر صندوق العمل لا دار للمرء بعد الموت يسكنها إلا الذي قبل الموت بانيها فإن بناها بخير طاب مسكنه وإن بناها بشر خاب بانيها أيها المسلمون ومما زادني فخرا وتيها وكدت بأخمصي أطأ الثريا دخولي تحت قوله يا عبادي وأن صيرت لي أحمد نبيا أيها المسلمون فأما موضوع خطبتنا اليوم وديدن حديثنا اليوم فهو حول شخصية عظيمة نبي من أنبياء الله تعالى، بل إنه الأب الثاني للأنبياء. قال تعالى: إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا حنيفا ولم يك من المشركين شاكرا لأنعمه اجتباه شاكرا لأنعمه اجتباه، فالله سبحانه وتعالى اجتباه كما أنه اصطفاه، وكما أن الله عز وجل اصطفى له الدين. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى: ومن يرغب عن ملة إبراهيم إلا من سفه نفسه، إلا من سفه نفسه. أيها المسلمون، my brothers and sisters in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in this few moments of our khutbah. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the bounties and the favors and the ni'mas and the blessings that He has bestowed upon us. The ni'mah and the blessing of existence, the ni'mah and the blessing of iman and faith and Islam, the ni'mah of Quran, the ni'mah of His messengers, and the final one being Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ni'mah and the blessing of His sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And brothers and sisters in Islam, as believers, as Muslims, as slaves of Allah, as servants of Allah, we live a journey and we live a life of being grateful to the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they all come from Him. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. And whatever bounty and blessing that you enjoy, that you have, that you cherish, only comes from Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, our life of 70 years, of 60 years, of 50 years, of 40 years, of whatever amount of time that Allah has given us, should be a life of gratitude, a life of being grateful, a life of praising and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah says, shakiran li an'umi. He was always grateful for the blessings of Allah. Regarding Nuh, Allah says, innahu kana abadan shakura. Verily indeed, he was a grateful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the war and the struggle and fight between you and shaitan, between us and shaitan, is that of gratefulness to Allah. Shaitan will inhibit, will obstruct, will stop, will do everything to make you forget to become grateful to Allah. That is his job. That is his fundamental assignment. Allah says in the Quran regarding shaitan, when he took the oath, when he went on the mission, because of his jealousy for Bani Adam, because of his jealousy for the human being, because the human being obeyed Allah, the human being obeyed the command of Allah. When Allah said, when the human being made a mistake, when Adam alayhi salam, وَعَصَى آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فَغَوَى ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَهَدَى. When Adam alayhi salam committed the sin, he repented.
He repented. He became humble. He comprehended and understood that he has made a mistake. But Shaitan was full of jealousy because Adam was made and created from clay and he was created from fire. So he saw himself superior. He was filled with arrogance. He was filled with pride. He was thinking that he was superior. So when Adam said, him being in the company of the angels, and Allah said to them, bow down to Adam. Usjudu li Adama. Bow down to Adam. Not sujood of honor for Adam. Shaitan refused. And because of his refusal, because of his rejection, because of his disobedience, Allah cast him. And then he took and he said, in Surah Al-A'raf, Allah says, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. I will approach them from the front and from behind, from their right side and from their left side, and you shall find a majority of them never being grateful. Not being grateful. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the essence of ibadah, the essence of worship, the essence of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is in the acknowledgement of being a servant of Allah, and in that, being grateful for everything that Allah has given us. That's why Allah says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا. If you were to try and count the blessings of Allah and the ni'mas of Allah on us, then la tuhsuha, just one of them, the weight of just one ni'mah that Allah has given to us, we cannot give it a value. We cannot give it a measure. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاهُ أَجْرَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِلَى آخِرِ الْآيَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we want to live with these few verses. We want to try and saturate, embed the meaning of these few verses of the Quran regarding Ibrahim alayhi salam in our hearts. Engrave that meaning in our souls and our minds. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the Quran has told us to follow the religion of Ibrahim. مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. The tradition, the way of life, the faith and the iman and the religion of Ibrahim alayhi salam, your father. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Then who turns away from the millah, the religion, the way of life of Ibrahim? In the Arabic language is a very unique language. It is a very rich language. It is a complete language. And according to research done in the University of Cape Town and some other universities, they say, these are papers that have been written in research, that almost every other language will die, will come to die, will vanish from the face of this earth, except for the Arabic language. Scientifically proven. So Arabic is a very unique language, is a very rich language, and enough it is for Arabic as an honor that it is revealed in the last book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quranan Arabian, غَيْرَ ذِي عِوَجٍ. A Quran that has been revealed, descended in Arabic, that has no crookedness, that has no defects, that has no shortcomings, that has no mistakes. So Allah says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ يَرْغَبُ إِلَى يَرْغَبُ فِي يَرْغَبُ بِ. In the Arabic language, if you take the verb يَرْغَبُ and you put in front of it certain words, certain letters that are known in the Arabic language as حُرُوفُ الْجَرْ, they change the meaning of the word يَرْغَبُ. So Allah says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. And who turns away from the millah and the tradition and the faith and the iman and the tawheed and the religion of Ibrahim? إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِيهَ نَفْسَهُ. Except for a fool. Except for someone who is foolish. Who is it that neglects the way of Ibrahim? The upward, straight faith of Ibrahim. إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِيهَ نَفْسَهُ. Except for he who is foolish. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاهُ أَجْرَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. Allah says, and indeed we give Ibrahim his reward in this dunya. وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And verily indeed, he is on the day of judgment from those in the company of the righteous. Then Allah says, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ, both are qira'as in the Quran. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. وَلَقَدْ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. In the previous verse. So Allah says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Who is it that turns away from the millah and the tradition of Ibrahim? إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِيَ نَفْسَهُ. Except for the foolish one. وَلَقَدْ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. And verily indeed Allah says, we chose him in this dunya. We chose him in this dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who chose him. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has the freedom to choose from his creation, from his servants, from his angels, from his earth, from his creation, however way he wants. He created the earth and he chose Makkah to be the most righteous place, the most blessed place. He created human beings and among them the most pure are the messengers and the prophets of Allah. And amongst the prophets and the pure, and amongst the rest of them, are the followers of these messengers and prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah yastafi min al-malaikati rusulan wa min al-nas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who chooses from the human beings and from also the angels. Wa innahu fil akhirati la min as-salihin. And verily indeed Ibrahim alayhi salam on the day of judgment is in the company of the righteous. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. When Allah said to him, submit yourself, surrender yourself. قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. He said, I surrender to Allah the Almighty. I surrender to Allah, Lord of the universe, maker, sustainer, and creator of the universe. أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Ibrahim alayhi salam submitted fully, wholly, completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole idea of submission, the whole idea of obedience. He says, أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Ibrahim alayhi salam, in his submission, he was complete. He was perfect. Allah says to us in the Quran, وَإِنَّ مِنْ شِيعَتِهِ لَإِبْرَاهِيمِ إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Ibrahim alayhi salam, In his action, he was completely submitted towards Allah. In his heart, he was completely submitted towards Allah. He came with a heart that is submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Ibrahim alayhi salam, in his faith, he was submitted to Allah. A pure belief and a refined and upright, clean, pure faith in Allah that has no idolatry, that has no shirk in it, that has no kufr in it, that has no nifaq in it. It's pure and clean iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember from the incident of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when they decided to throw him into the fire, and they were burning this fire for over 7 days. And the fire was so big that even when a bird flew over that fire, that bird would either fall into that fire or burnt by the waves that are emitting from the fire. And everyone was, you know, collectively participating in the lighting of the fire. The children, the women, the elderly, the young men, everyone for 7 days. And they were thinking of how they were going to throw Ibrahim into this fire. And in some of the others, according to what the Mufassirin say, Shaitan appeared to them in the form of a human being. And he showed them how to make a catapult. In Arabic, they call it al-minjiniq. He taught them how to make a catapult, so that they put Ibrahim in this catapult, and they pull him, and he throws him into the fire. And when they threw Ibrahim, angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those responsible for the waters, the one responsible for the winds, and even Jibreel alayhi salam, they wanted to come to rescue Ibrahim alayhi salam. Alaka bi haja. They were telling him, should we help you? Should we do something for you? And Ibrahim says, no. Amma anta fala. Amma Allahu amma Rabbi fabala. But as for Allah, yes. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakil is what he said. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Ibrahim. Commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam. Commanded fire. Wa qulna ya naru kuni bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. And Allah commanded the fire to cool down and become conducive so that Ibrahim alayhi salam can be in that fire but will have no harm, will face no harm in that fire. In some of the athar, they say Allah made some grass to germinate, and they brought for him a chair from Jannah, and Jibreel and another angel were sitting with him right there. And Namrud could see Ibrahim sitting in the middle of the fire, under him a grass, and he was sitting on a chair. This is the iman of Ibrahim. And this is the faith and the iman and the yaqeen of the messengers of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَى اللَّهُ فَبِهُدَاهُمْ مُقْتَدِهُ وَكُلًّا نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. And whenever we narrate to you, Allah says to us, the stories of the messengers and the prophets, we tell them to you so that it strengthens your iman. Brothers, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. When Allah said to Ibrahim, Aslim, surrender yourself. And it is as if Allah gave da'wah directly to Ibrahim to become Muslim, to take Islam, to submit. قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And therefore Ibrahim submitted. So we are supposed to become submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our ibadah, in our salah, in our fasting, in our zakah, in our birrul walidain, in our recitation of the Quran, in our dealing with our neighbors, in when you are dealing with your friends and your colleagues at work. The submissiveness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be part of your nature, should be the inherent fabric of your nature, that you are submissive to Allah. When Allah says do, you do. When Allah says don't, you don't. What Allah has said is haram, you stay away from it, you submit. What Allah has obligated over you, you do it submissively by surrendering. This is the essence of Islam. In his action, Ibrahim alayhi salam was submissive to Allah alone. And his heart became pure because of that submissiveness to Allah. That's why Allah says regarding Ibrahim, when he was speaking, when Allah was telling us about Ibrahim, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. A day on that day of judgment, a day that no wealth will be of avail to you, or your children will be of no avail to you, no help to you. Your wealth will be of no help to you, neither will your children and your grandchildren be of help to you, illa man ata Allah bi qalbin salim, except for the one who comes with a pure and clean heart. Then Allah says to us, brothers and sisters in Islam,
وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ, and Ibrahim alayhi salam left it as a legacy for his descendants and for his children, and he adored them and recommended to them. وَيَعْقُوبُ, and likewise did Ya'qub alayhi salam. They recommended to their children and their progeny and their descendants.
Ya baniya, O our children, inna Allah astafa lakum ad-deena.
Verily indeed, Allah has chosen for you a way of life.
Subhanallah al-Azim. Subhanallah al-Azim.
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وحسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, the ulama very recently, some great scholars have been writing on a subject, and that is our obligation towards the future generation. Obligations towards the future generation. And they categorize this under the chapters of fiqh. Is it fardu ayn or fardu kifaya? Is it a universal obligation or is it a specific obligation? Our obligation towards our future generation. And this is what the verse is telling us.
وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ,
and indeed Ibrahim left it behind as a legacy. The legacy of iman, the legacy of tawheed, the legacy of abandoning shirk, the legacy of submitting to Allah, the legacy of obeying Allah, the legacy of taking pride in Islam and in your faith.
وَيَعْقُوبُ, and likewise did Ya'qub.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ. Verily indeed, Allah has appointed and chosen for you a deen, a way of life.
فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ.
Don't you dare die except in a state of submission, except in a state of Islam.
أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ, Allah is telling us.
أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ,
were you present, إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتُ,
when Ya'qub alayhi salam was approached by death.
إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ,
when he said to his children,
مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي,
what are you going to worship when I leave you behind? How are you going to live when I leave you behind?
And Ya'qub, he wanted to see if he has left behind and he has fulfilled his obligation towards the future.
He wanted to see if he has fulfilled his mission and that he has conveyed the message.
مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي,
قالوا, they said, نعبد إلهك, we will worship your Lord, وإله آبائك, and the Lord of your father, إبراهيم وإسحاق ويعقوب, إلها واحدا, we will worship and continue to be devoted to the single faith, to the Iman of your fathers, Ibrahim and Ishaq and Ismail, إلها واحدا, only one Lord, Allah alone, ونحن له مسلمون, and indeed to him we submit. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه, ثم الصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أيها المسلمون, brothers and sisters in Islam, I want us to finish with one verse that comes in the context of what we were discussing and what we were reminding ourselves in the verses about Ibrahim. تلك أمة قد خلت لها ما كسبت ولكم ما كسبتم ولا تسألون عما كانوا يعملون. And as the verses continue, as Allah is telling us regarding the legacy of His messengers and His prophets, including Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub and Musa alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam, when Allah is telling us regarding their legacy of Iman and faith, regarding their legacy of submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pure and clean in their faith, in their action, in their hearts, Allah says, صِبْغَةَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةَ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةً وَنَحْنُ لَهُ عَابِدُونَ. صِبْغَةَ اللَّهِ, and such is the color of Allah. You know, in the olden days in Christianity, they used to baptize someone to become a Christian. And then when they would baptize them, they would use a certain color in the water. But Muslims never do baptizing. But because of their action, Allah tells them that whatever color you're using, the color of Allah is the most beautiful. Sibaghat Allah, the color of Allah. Now this has connotations in its meanings. It means the signs of Allah, the flag of Allah, the message of Allah, the brand of Allah. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةً, and who indeed is better in brand? Whose brand can be better than the brand of Allah? Whose color can be better than the color of Allah? Whose message can be better than the message of Allah? And this should be the attitude of every believer. It should emanate from every believer, whether you're in school, whether you're at work, whether you're doing your business, whether you're at home, when you're in the masjid, when you're walking down the street, for the brothers and the sisters